गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स.
ओके, होप सो द वॉइस इज ऑडिबल टू यू क्लियरली. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट दिस क्लास. सी द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर टुडेज क्लास, दैट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी एट अ डेप्थ ऑफ 1600 किलोमीटर इज इक्वल टू. सो हियर टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग द क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन That is, in the last class I told you that is acceleration due to gravity depends on the four factors. The acceleration due to gravity, what all the four factors are there? One is the shape of the earth. So first factor is shape of the earth. Second factor is that is at what height the object is placed. And the third factor is that is the depth. And the fourth factor is due to the rotation. So these are the four factors on which the acceleration due to gravity depends. So today we are discussing the questions based on the height and the depth. Okay. So rotation mele astain questions barala. Actually the formula ide, but ast depth agadre mele questions kelala. So we will see the remaining two points. So here in this question, what they are giving, the value of acceleration due to gravity at a depth of 1600 kilometer. Is equal to so depth na kottidare 1600 kilometer anta and then next here radius of the earth is also given in the question 6400 kilometer we need to calculate the acceleration due to gravity so see how to calculate the acceleration due to so if you know the formula you can also try it here the formula is acceleration due to gravity at a depth is given by It is g into bracket r e minus d upon r e. Okay, so actually here the formula is like this. That is g into bracket 1 minus d divided by r. So inside the bracket any the then now LCM to konde simplify madkolta idivi. That is r minus d divided by r. Okay, so here r e when you are writing it means that the radius of the earth aste matte enilla so we can substitute the value here okay so however you feels easy to simplify you can simplify that so it is 9.8 into bracket the radius of the earth is given 6400 so 6400 minus 1600 both are in the kilometers so I'll keep it as it is in the kilometer itself divided by this is the radius of the earth again it is 6400 So you can simplify this. Check how much you are getting the answer. So let me know A, B, C, D which answer you are getting. Okay. Subtract that is 6400 minus 1600. So when you do that, 4600. Well, students, yes, please check the answers. So subtraction is 4800. 4000 divided by 6400. Here, this is equal to, this is 9.8. Inside the bracket, it is subtraction is 4800 divided by 6400. So, these two zeros we can cancel. So, 48 divided by 64 we can do. It becomes 9.8 into 0.75. So, 9.8 into 0.75, when you multiply, option C you will get. Yes, 7.35. Yes, correct, Hema. Option C, 7.35 meter per second square. Okay, so please copy down. We will go for the next question. Option C is the answer. So please copy down simultaneously. Andre jasti time waste agalla. See the next question. A space station is at a height equal to the radius of the earth. Okay. So in the question, what they are saying, a space station is at a height equal to the radius of the earth. If VE is the escape velocity on the surface of the earth, the same on the space station is dash times VE. So what is the meaning of the question here? That is a space station is there. Suppose if you, this is the earth, a space station is at a height equal to the radius of the earth. So here, whatever the radius of the earth is there, at same height, here we have a space station. Okay. If VE is the velocity of the escape velocity of the on the surface of the earth. So on the surface of the earth, the escape velocity is VE. The same on the space station is. So on the space station, what is the value of escape velocity? Means how many times of the earth anta kelta idare. Okay. Hope so the question is clear to you. So in the given question, it is described that whatever the radius of the earth is there at the same radius or at the same distance. And suppose this is a 6,400 kilometer radius. 6,400 kilometer from the surface of the earth, you have a space station. Earth to the escape velocity VE adre. Space station to escape velocity A nanta kelta idare. Okay. So let us see how to simplify this. So see here, the escape velocity on the surface of the earth is given by, this is VE is equal to under root of 2GM upon R. So this is the formula for the escape velocity where M is the mass and R is the radius of the earth. Okay. So similarly, when you are right station, the escape velocity is given by, this is for the phase space station. This is given by under root of 2GM. Upon R plus H. Okay, this is equal to. So now here what they are saying here, students, height test anta helta idare, height is equal to the radius of the earth. They are saying that height is equal to radius of the earth. Therefore, they are right. We can write it as what? R plus R. Yes. So further you simplify, that is root of 2GM divided by 2R. Root of 2GM divided by 2R. Okay. So now, this is equal to, so first equation ilen barkondidivi, I'll name it as equation 1. Now, see the next step, don't cancel 2, 2, okay? So 2 anna cancel madkobedi. So here, I can rearrange this above term as 1 upon root 2, I'll keep it outside. And inside the bracket, I'll write under root term as it is, root of 2gm upon r. Yes? Hope so there is no confusion. So whatever a 1 upon under root of 2 is there, that under root of 2, I have taken it outside. Aita. So under root of 2 anna horakade tagolta idivi. Mattenu rearrangement madidivi aste mattenilla. So whatever the under root of 1 by 2 is there, keep it as it is. So equation 1 nodi. What is root of 2 gm by r illi? That is nothing but the escape velocity of the earth. So into escape velocity of the earth. So il question alen helta idare. If VE is the escape velocity on the surface of the earth, the same on the space station is 1 upon root 2 times VE. How that is nothing but option C is the answer. Yes. Escape velocity of the earth we have written under root of 2 gm by r. Then on the space station. So on the space station is root of 2gm divided by r plus h. But h chain is it is the radius of the earth itself. So r plus r becomes 2r. So further if you simplify 1 upon root 2 horagade tagolbodu. So therefore option C is the right answer. Yes, any doubt?
Ma'am, what is the meaning of VS?
VSC is the space station escape velocity. Escape velocity of the space station. So that for our understanding, we are writing it as VS. So this is also escape velocity, but on the space station. So in the question they have given for Earth, it is VE. So for our understanding, we have taken for the space station as VS. Yes, any other doubt? Okay, students, going for the next question. Okay. See this question. The value of acceleration So the surface of the Earth, the value of acceleration due to gravity x. At what depth inside the Earth is the value of acceleration due to gravity has the same value of x? So first understand the question. So you can divide the question two parts. So what they are saying here, see, the value of acceleration due to gravity at a height of 10 kilometer from the surface of the Earth is x. So suppose this is the surface of the Earth. From the surface of the Earth at a height of 10 kilometer, at a height of 10 kilometer, the value of acceleration due to gravity is x. At what depth inside? So ಇದೇನಾಯ್ತು height ಮೇಲೆ x ಅಂತ ಆಗಿದೆ. So next ಏನ್ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದಾರೆ, at what depth? ಆಯ್ತಾ? So you need to imagine this figure little. So at what depth? Depth ಎಷ್ಟು depth ಅಲ್ಲಿ we have the same acceleration due to gravity, that is x. Okay, suppose if you are not understanding, I'll give you example. So from the surface of the earth 10 kilometer ಅಲ್ಲಿ acceleration due to gravity 9.8 ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಅಸ್ಯೂಮ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಸೊ ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಎಕ್ಸಲೇಷನ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಗ್ರಾವಿಟಿ ಅಟ್ 10 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಅರ್ತ್ ಅಬೌವ್, ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಅಬೌವ್ ದ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ 9.8 meter ಪರ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್. ಅವ್ರು ಏನ್ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದಾರೆ, ಎಷ್ಟು ಡೆಪ್ತ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ವೆನ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಅರ್ತ್, ಸೊ ಅಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಡೆಪ್ತ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸಲೇಷನ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಗ್ರಾವಿಟಿ, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ 9.8. That is the meaning of the question. So see, see what we can understand here, that is the acceleration due to gravity at a height h is given as x and height is given as 10. So ನೀವು ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬಹುದು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಚ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ಮತ್ತೆ ನೀವು 10 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಬೇಡ. ಸೊ ಬೆಟರ್ ಐ ಟೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಜಿ ಎಚ್, ಸಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ತಗೊಳ್ತೀನಿ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಜಿ ಎಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ದೆನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಎಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 10 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಚ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಲೆಸ್ ದನ್ ದ ರೇಡಿಯಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಅರ್ತ್. Hope so you agree with this point, because we know that the radius of the earth is how much? 6,400 kilometer. How the our question al h value is kottidare, it is just 10 kilometer. So compared to 6,400 kilometer, 10 kilometer is very less value. How the so therefore what we can say, since h is much much less than r value, we can write the formula of gh as the GH is equal to G into bracket 1 minus 2H divided by R. GH is equal to G into bracket 1 minus 2H divided by R. So this I'll keep it as equation 1. This is first part of the question. So in the second part, what they are saying in the question, that is your GH is equal to G, your GH is equal to GD. What is the meaning here? That is acceleration due to gravity at that height is equal to acceleration due to gravity at same depth. Okay, so here in the question it is given that GH is equal to GD. At what depth inside the earth the value of acceleration due to gravity has the same value, so therefore GH is equal to D. Now we can write the formula for GH and GD, that is G into bracket 1 minus 2H by R. This is equal to what is GD? It is 1 minus D divided by R. So this is G in bracket 1 minus D by R. So you need to calculate the value of D, because H is given, R you can cancel, you can calculate what is the value of D. Right? Yes, so GG, we can cancel on both the side. The remaining term is 1 minus 2h by r, 1 minus d by r. Okay, so in exam, in CET exam, you no need to follow all these steps. So in the question, what they are saying, that is in the question, they are saying that acceleration due to gravity at that height is equal to acceleration due to gravity at the same depth. So therefore, directly we can substitute the formula, that is g into bracket 1 minus 2h by r is equal to g into bracket 1 minus b divided by r. So g will get cancelled and it is 1 minus 2h by r is equal to 1 minus d divided by r. Okay, so further this one also we can cancel. So 1 will get cancelled because il plus 1 ide idu ni kade tagond bandre minus 1 agutte. So 1 1 we can cancel. Minus sign will also get cancelled. Hope so you will understand the steps. Little shortcut I am taking. So h value is given in the question. It is given as 10 kilometer divided by r, which is equal to d divided by r. Again, r will also get cancelled. Therefore, d is equal to students. It is 20 kilometer. Means, what is the meaning here? So from the surface of the earth 10 kilometer alli en acceleration due to gravity ide, depth 20 kilometer alli we have the same acceleration due to gravity, and that same acceleration due to gravity question alli x anta helidare. Yes, if any doubt is there, any confusion is there, please ask.
No, ma'am.
Okay, this copy down students, we will go for the next. The next question. Yes, see, so you can see that this is asked in the 2021. Two bodies of masses 8 kg are placed at the vertices A and B of an equilateral triangle ABC. So you have here a equilateral triangle. You can name this equilateral triangle as ABC. ABC. A third body of mass 2 kg is placed at the centroid. So hope so you know in the triangle this is considered as the centroid. So the centroid is denoted as G of the triangle. So here the third body of mass 2 kg. Okay. So here in the question, what they are saying, two bodies of masses 8 kg are placed at the vertices A and B. So our triangle only two vertices they have taken, that is A and B. So this is A. So I'll name it as this is as A, this as B, and this as C. Okay, so A, B, C. At A and B, they have placed 8 kg body. Then next slide, they are placing the third body whose mass is 2 kg. Okay, whose mass is 2 kg. If AG is equal to BG is equal to CG is equal to 1 meter. So which means that you need to join this one. So because this is the G, the centroid, you need to join this here. That is AG is equal to BG is equal to CG is equal to, this is 1 meter, which is given in the question. Where should a fourth body of mass 4 kg be placed so that the resultant force on the 2 kg body is zero? So what they are asking here, where you have to keep 4 kg body, where you have to keep 4 kg body so that the resultant force at the centroid is zero. Result force centroid mele yestabeku, it should be zero. Hagadre 4 kg yellidbekanta question kelta idare. Okay. So see how to solve this one. Hope so the question is clear to you. Once again, I am explaining the question. So you have an equilateral triangle. In this equilateral triangle, you are placing the two bodies. I am naming it as A, B, C. So 8 kg, 8 kg are placing at A and B. The third body at the centroid G, you are keeping the third body whose mass is 2 kg. Here in the question, again, it is given that AG is equal to BG is equal to CG is equal to 1 meter. That is given. Okay. So next, what they are asking in question alone, find maadbekagide, where you have to keep the 4 kg. So 4 kg, where you have to keep so that the resultant force on the centroid, andre 2 kg andre yellide, it is at the centroid. So at the centroid, the force becomes zero. Okay. The question is, hope so it is clear to everyone. If you want, you can copy down the question. So let us see how to solve this. Okay, according to the question, see how to solve this. See, first we need to just take a figure for understanding. A, B, C. This is the centroid G. AG, BG, CG, which is equal to 1 meter. That is also given in the question. Okay. So now you see here, the given is what? That is AG is equal to BG is equal to CG is equal to 1 meter. AG is equal to BG is equal to CG is equal to 1 meter. So for our understanding, I'll just take it as R anta. Okay, so distance anna R anta denote maadkoltaidivi. The resultant force of F1 and F2 is along GD. So here we are going to consider that here the resultant force for these three, we will take it along this direction. Okay, so for here I'm changing the color for your understanding purpose. See, along this direction we are taking the resultant force, and that is GD, that is taken as. So here GD is the resultant force for F1 and F2. So in the figure, which is F1 and F2, see, so this is taken as F1, this is F1, and this is taken as F2. So F1 and F2. Okay, so these are the two forces, because ille mass kottidare avaru, howda? So ille nam mass estide 8 kg, 8 kg irodrinda. Therefore, from AG, this is F1. For BG, this is F2. The resultant of these two is GD, that is along this direction. So figure. So this is GD, this is F1, this is F2. Okay, one more figure. Yes. Here, what they are saying, F1 and F2 is along GD, so that the 4 kg is placed along GC. So, one thing what we need to understand, this is the resultant force. ಸೊ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಗಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ವೇರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕೀಪ್ ದ ಅದರ್ ಮಾಸ್, ದ ಅದರ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್, ಹೌದಾ? ಸೊ ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಕೀಪಿಂಗ್ ಎನಿ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಟೇಬಲ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಟು, ಇದು ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಟ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್, ಇದು ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎರಡು ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಡೌನ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಂ ಜಿ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ವೇಟ್, ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಅಪ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಎಫ್ ಒನ್ ಎಫ್ ಟು, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಫ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಫ್ ಟು, ಇದ್ರದ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಈ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಟು ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್, ಎಸ್? ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸಿ, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್, ಸೊ ದ ಅದರ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ಜಿ ಸಿ, ದ ಅದರ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ಜಿ ಸಿ. ಸೊ ನಾವ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಸಿ. ಸೊ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಎ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದಾರೆ, ಅಟ್ ಸಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದಾರೆ. ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಬಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದಾರೆ, ಅಟ್ ಎ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಪಿ ಆನ್ ದ ಲೈನ್ ಸಿ ಜಿ, ಬಟ್ ಪಿ ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 1/√2, ಪಿ ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 0.5, 2 meter. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಇನ್ ದ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದಾರೆ, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಜಿ ಸಿ, ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ಜಿ ಸಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿದೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಜಿ ಸಿ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ಜಿ ಸಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್, ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಪಿ, ದಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಪಿ, ಹೌದಾ? ಸೊ ನಾವೀಗ ಏನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಜಿ ಪಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಅನ್ನ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾಗಿದೆ. ಎಸ್, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇದು ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಕೇಳಿ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ. ಎಸ್, ಜಿ ಪಿ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಎವ್ರಿವೇರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಜಿ ಪಿ ಜಿ ಪಿ, ಅದು ಎಷ್ಟು ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಒಂದೇ ನಮ್ದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮೇನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಎಫ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎಫ್ ಟು, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಬೋತ್ ಆರ್ 8 kg, 8 kg ಮಾಸ್ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಎಫ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎಫ್ ಟು ಅಂತ ಆಗತ್ತೆ. ಎಸ್, ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಜಿ ಎಮ್ ಒನ್ ಇಂಟು ಎಮ್ ಟು ಅಪಾನ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಕೀಪ್ ಜಿ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಟು. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಒನ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ 8 kg ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಜಿ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ ಮಾಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 2 kg ಇದೆ, ಅಪಾನ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್, ಆರ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ದಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಆಸ್ 1 meter, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ 1 square. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ 8 2s are 16, 16 ಅಪಾನ್ 1 square ಇಸ್ 1, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಎಫ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎಫ್ ಟು ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 16 ಇಂಟು ಜಿ, ಸೊ ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಕ್ವೇಶನ್ 1. ಎಸ್, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಎಫ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎಫ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಬೋತ್ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಮಾಸ್, ಸೊ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗ್ರಾವಿಟೇಷನಲ್ ಲಾ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಇಸ್ ಜಿ ಎಮ್ ಒನ್ ಇಂಟು ಎಮ್ ಟು ಅಪಾನ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎಮ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ 8 kg, ಎಮ್ ಟು ಇಸ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್, 2 kg ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ 1 square. ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎಫ್ ಟು ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 16 ಇಂಟು ಜಿ, ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಡಿ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಜಿ ಇರೋದು ಎಕ್ಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಗ್ರಾವಿಟೇಷನಲ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಗ್ರಾವಿಟೇಷನಲ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗ್ರಾವಿಟೇಷನಲ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಐ ಆಮ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ನಾವ್, ಸಿ ರಿಸಲ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಫ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಫ್ ಟು. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್, ರಿಸಲ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಫ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಫ್ ಟು, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ರೈಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಫ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಬೈ ಅಂಡರ್ ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಫ್ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಎಫ್ ಟು ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ 2 F1 ಇಂಟು ಎಫ್ ಟು ಕಾಸ್ ಥೀಟಾ, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್, ಸೊ ಎಫ್ ಒನ್ ಎಫ್ ಟು ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇಸ್ 16 g, ಸೊ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ 16 g ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಹೋಲ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ 16 g ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಹೋಲ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಮೈನಸ್, ವೈ ಮೈನಸ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಎಫ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಫ್ ಟು ಈ ತರ ಇದೆ, ಹೌದಾ? ಎಸ್, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಆಂಗಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ 120 degree, ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ವಾಟ್, ಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ 120. ಎಸ್, Yes. So here cos of 120. So cos of 120, if you solve here, that is cos of 180 minus 60. So cos 180 minus theta is minus cos theta. Therefore, it is minus cos of 60. So cos 60 is 1 by 2. So minus 1 by 2. So now here you can see. So 2 into 16g into 16g into minus. So we'll plus it first. Okay. So this is minus 1 by 2. Yes. So this 2 we can cancel. So next will be 16g its whole square plus 16g its whole square plus 16 into 16 is there. Again, we can the plus into minus. Here minus will come. So again, this becomes 16g whole square. See. Yes. So here 1 plus 16g, 1 minus 16g square will get cancelled. We have only 16g whole square. So square and square root will get cancelled. Therefore, our f dash will be how much? F dash will be 16g. F dash is 16g. Yes. Please ask if you are not understanding anything. Illivare students. So this question is asked in 2021. So here forces are equal from that F1 is equal to F2 is equal to we got 16g. Result and find out this one is 16g by there. And G, capital G is universal gravitational constant. It is not centroid. It is universal gravitational constant. Any doubt till here? Yes, last one step is there. Illenadru doubt idre keli. Or everything is doubt. Yes, Hema, Monica, Shehnaz, Tejasvi, Dhanashree, Chaitra. Okay. So the last step. So now we have now we, so in the question it is also given that the force between the fourth body and the third body at a distance if we as d and the resultant force is zero there. So we need to consider is f dash plus f double dash is equal to zero. So if that the what I think we will make a question note for him, but it is I don't know. So see here in the question it is given that where should a full body of mass 4 kg be placed so that the resultant force 2 kg body is zero. Yes, you have copied down that, or I need to write it once again. So just main steps I'll write. So first we got F1 is equal to F2 is equal to 16g. Then later we have calculated F dash, that also we got 16g. Now here what we are calculating, at what distance we need to keep the third body, right? So now, according to the question, these two forces, the resultant is zero. Okay. So F dash already it is calculated. It is 16 G plus F double dash is gravitational formula. That is G into M1 into M2. So M1 is ನೀವು ಎಷ್ಟು ಕೆ ಜಿ ಇಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರ 4 ಕೆ ಜಿ ಮಾಸ್ ಇಂಟು ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಕೆ ಜಿ ಮಾಸ್ ಇದೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 2 ಕೆ ಜಿ ಇದೆ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಅಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕೀಪ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಹೌದಾ ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಸೊ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಡಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ 16 ಜಿ ಪ್ಲಸ್ 4 2 is 8 g upon b square, which is equal to 0. Yes, therefore, 8 g upon b square is equal to minus 16 g. Yes, g, g we can cancel. Then next we require d value. Therefore, d square is equal to 8 upon 16 minus kuda irathe. Okay, so 8 ones are 8 twos are, therefore here d square is 1 by 2, therefore d is equal to 1 upon root 2. Okay, which means that according to the option, so option al nivu nodidre alli en kottidare option B at a point P in CG such that PG is equal to 1 upon root 2. Yes, if any doubt is there here, please ask. Otherwise, copy down the solution. Yes, completed everyone. If this is completed, I'll take one more question from 2022. Completed. So tell me, I'll write the question here. So this is in 2022. See, yeld column kottidare, match the least one and least two. So first least one. So in the least one here we have first one, gravitational constant. First one we have gravitational constant. Second, we have gravitational potential energy. C, we have gravitational potential. C, we have gravitational potential. D, we have gravitational intensity. Okay, so this is least one. So please write down simultaneously. In least two, we have the dimension formulas. So this is L2 T raised to minus 2. Here we have M raised to minus 1, L raised to 3, T raised to minus 2. Here we have L T raised to minus 2. Fourth, we have M L square T raised to minus 2. So in the least 2, akade 1, 2, 3, 4. Sorry, here we will make it as 1, 2, 3, 4. And this side, I'll make it as A, B, C, D. So that your answering will be easy for you. So this side, I'm writing it as A, B, C, D. There we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So you just, actually in the options, they have given. So question paper, they have given. Choose the below correct answer. Anta they have given for A, which answer for B, C, D, like that. But here, what you do, you just write and tell me For one, which one will come? For two, which one will come? For three, for four, which one will come? Yes, one at least you can tell for gravitational constant. There is no confusion directly. You can tell that. Remaining, you just need to think. Yes, for gravitational constant, P is right. So remaining three. Yes. So for gravitational constant, B is right. For remaining, okay, if you don't know the formula for the remaining, I'll just write the formulas here. You can just see that. So gravitational constant, I'll not write. You know that one. So B Antu Bharata, this is for the first. Yes. So next one we will see remaining. That is gravitational potential energy anta kottidare. I'll give you the formula, you can just try. The gravitational potential energy is given by, it is G M1 into M2 upon R. It is G M1 into M2 upon R. Actually minus varathe, but for dimensions minus is not required. So I have written the formula, new try maadi. This is gravitational potential energy. Gravitational potential, third one formula. So for the third one, again minus gm upon r, minus illu ide, but for dimensions it is not required. But the gravity is given by I is equal to gm upon r, is gm upon r. Being three formulas I have given you, just check out what answers you are getting.
For second, it is D, ma'am.
For second one, it is D. That is M raised to 1, L raised to 2, T raised to minus 3. Yes.
And for third is A, ma'am.
Yes. So whatever we have solved, based on that, you can just check out few more questions from different books. Gravitational intensity will be a new formula for you. So you can just take down the formula. ನೀವು ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ questions ಅನ್ನ simplify ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. Okay. So this completes the gravitation lesson, students. Yes, when you have the midterm exams, this when midterm exams are there. So next class, okay, it is late, no? Okay, no problem. So in the next class, we will start with the new topic. Okay, we will see motion in a plane, that is remaining, and system of particles, it is remaining from first part of the chapter, this one section. So we will cover next new topic. We will meet in the next class, students. Thank you.